One of the biggest hardware improvements with the new NVIDIA RTX graphics card, specifically the 2080 and 2080ti, although obviously the 2070 as well, is that they have the new and improved NVENC encoder. That is the hardware X264 encoder that is built into the GPU, and we've seen this from a number of past generation of cards, and it's something that a lot of people do use to stream with. But there's always been the battle of whether that actual output, the video output, is good enough to justify using that over X.264 with your CPU's encoder. In this video, we're going to explain the setup, this bit, and then we're going to talk about the actual hardware performance, so you know, your FPS in games for you the streamer, and then what it's like for your viewers who are watching your stream and the local recording if you're doing any. So let's start off with how we're going to test everything. First of all, we're testing three games, CSGO, PUBG and Fortnight, all on their max settings. We're testing at 1080p and we're using OBS to stream to Twitch and do a local recording. In terms of streaming to Twitch, we're doing that at 1080p 60 with a 6000 kilobit per second bitrate, and then we're also using a separated encoder, or a second instance of the encoder, for the indistinguishable file quality for the local recording. We're also using the very fast preset for the streaming side of things, obviously using the CPU to encode, and we're using, as I said, the same encoder twice. So for testing the CPU, we're stress testing it as hard as we can, so that is both streaming, encoding the stream, and encoding a separate local quality file. And then we're also, again with NVENC, using NVENC for both the local recording and the stream as well. The hardware I'm using here is an RTX 2080 Ti and an Intel 9900K. Of course, this will give you an idea of how well the 9900K does perform in streaming and gaming, but I'm doing a full video comparing the 9900K to the 2700X, so if you want to see that one, make sure you subscribe for more videos, because that's coming out relatively soon. And my final bit of explanation for the video is just talking through the performance results. It's a little bit complicated, so let's run you through a screenshot of one of the results and talk you through what it all means. So in the top right-hand corner, you have the game. So in this case, it's Fortnite. Below that, you have the graphics card, which is the RTX 2080 Ti, same for all of them. And then below that, you have which type of result we're looking at. In the frame here, we've got average, but you can also see 5% mins and 95% max. Now, average is just the average FPS result. The 5% minimums are effectively a sort of weighted average, if you like, for, or a more real-world minimum. So while, you know, something like fraps will give you a very low minimum number, that is the, you know, perhaps only happens once or twice in your entire 5 minute benchmarking session, the 5% minimums give you a more reasonable number of what you can expect your minimums and maximums to be, and the 95% is just the exact same thing but for the maximums. In terms of the actual bars in the graph itself, they're split into three sections. So the leftmost section, that one is your standard FPS results, that is the average minimum or maximum FPS results that I collected in my testing with stock, so no streaming at all, X.264, which is obviously using the CPU to encode the stream and your local recording, and then NVENC for the same thing. The next set of results is the FPS difference between either X.264 or NVENC to the stock. So that is obviously NVENC compared to the stock and X.264 compared to the stock, to give you an idea of how much performance you lose depending on which one you're using. And then the last section is the same numbers but in percentages, to give you a more relative idea of how much FPS you're losing and how much you might actually see a kind of performance loss. And finally, there is one mildly anomalous result with using NVENC actually had higher minimums than the stock. This is just generally margin of error, but it will be listed as 0% as the graphs can't show minus percentage, but I'll include all of the original results on my website so you can take a look at that in the links down below. So with all of that explaining done, let's get to the results.
So starting off with CSGO, on the averages we can see the X.264 is losing about 43% of its total average FPS here, with 19% only being lost by NVENC. On the minimums, it's pretty much the same story, 37 and 16%, and some pretty healthy minimums, although obviously X.264 losing a fair bit, and in the maximums, it's a pretty big loss again on X.264, but not so much of a loss on NVENC. In terms of Battlegrounds, we're looking again at a 30% loss for X.264, with only 18% loss with NVENC, and again, some impressive minimums as well. The minimums here are the one erroneous result I was talking about, where the minimums were actually higher than stock, but again, you can look at the actual numbers themselves. And then on the maximums, it's basically what you'd expect. We're looking at a pretty similar result either way, with actually X264 slightly ahead. In terms of Fortnight, again, we're looking at 24% loss for X264, with only 16% performance loss with NVENC, and again, a very similar result with minimums of 25 and 16, and the maximums holding a pretty similar result too, with 17 and 13. So overall, definitely an impressive shout for NVENC, with it winning basically everything in comparison.
So as you saw, NVENC generally beats out X264 in terms of FPS and your experience. In my actual gaming experience, the only one that I really noticed between the two and between stock was X.264 using on CSGO. That was incredibly choppy. As you saw, it was a 43% decrease using X.264 versus, I think, the 19% drop that NVENC had. In terms of PUBG, again, all on averages, but you're looking 18% instead of 30%, and Fortnite was 16 instead of 24. So generally a much nicer play experience, especially as I said on CSGO. So now we've had a look at what it's like for you, the streamer, and your FPS results and your general gaming experience, but what is it like for your viewers? What is the end video quality like? Well, I'm using the locally recorded file because, well, that's the easiest one for me to get access to since it recorded to my own hard drive. And that one is obviously going to be not necessarily the exact same quality as the stream, but generally speaking, it will give you a good indication of how well the encoder does at actually processing your videos. So I'm going to be doing a side-by-side comparison here, and I want you guys to comment in the description down below. I'm going to show you footage from all three games, and we're going to have an A side and a B side. Now, the footage won't be identical because there were multiple playthroughs and stuff like that, but they will be similar in the area and the map, for example, for PUBG and Fortnite, and they will be very similar overall gameplay, so you can see which one is which. So feel free to let me know in the comments down below which one you think is X.264 and which one is NVENC in the comments, and I'll let you know in a minute, and no cheating, which one is which. Because I'm editing this after I film it, obviously, I'm going to leave all the results over there for you. Take a look at them and see how well you did in the comments, in your comment, and let me know by replying to your own comment how well you did and how many got right there. But for me, especially if you did notice anything in particular, do let me know as well. I would love to hear that sort of detailed feedback. But either way, for me, I couldn't tell the difference. I had them side by side on a 1440p monitor, and obviously this is 1080p footage. So in theory, it should have been easier for me to tell because they were stretched out a fair bit, but I couldn't tell the difference. Now, of course, that doesn't mean that, you know, no one can, but from my experience, I can highly recommend NVENC as the encoder of choice for streamers and gamers who want to record their footage. Of course, it's faster in terms of FPS. It was faster in every game that I tested, and that's generally going to be true because you're not bottlenecking your CPU in any way, and the X.264 encoder that's built into the cards is one that is a separate part that is not normally used while gaming, so you're essentially just utilizing an extra chip effectively rather than trying to make use of the existing chips that are there. And of course, when you're streaming, especially if you're doing any scaling and stuff like that, that will be done by your CPU. So while you do still need a good and you know, powerful CPU to stream, you don't necessarily need as good of a CPU if you're using your graphics card to do all of the rendering. And I think it's generally what I would recommend, especially if you're just starting out. Now, does that mean that I recommend going out and buying an RTX card over everything else? Well, that's pretty hard to recommend. If you're already in the market and you're already considering buying an RTX card, then possibly this could be a good thing to sort of tip you over the edge. But if you're someone who isn't necessarily already looking at this sort of price point, or if you don't really stream that much and you just want a decent quality footage, then the old gen NVENC still does plenty fine. So I wouldn't necessarily recommend the huge price differences that are between the 10 and 20 series right now, that this new version of NVENC is worth that. But of course, that is definitely up to you, and I would love to hear what you think in the comments down below. Is this so much improved that this is worth an RTX card, or is this more just a nice feature that if you already have one, you'd make use of? Let me know in the comments down below. Now, of course, if this video has convinced you to pick up an RTX card, then I'll leave some links in the description down below. I've also done a full review of the Zotac 2080 and 2080i, and I've done a comparison of all three of the cards that are here, or at least the 2080 versions anyway, to give you an idea of which one you might go with if you are interested. So feel free to take a look at those videos. I'll leave a card up above or on the end cards down there. Otherwise, that is kind of it. If you want to support this channel and keep me making these videos, it takes me like full days to do the testing just for this video, and I've still got more testing for the 2700X to come, so feel free to stick around and make sure you subscribe for those. But if you want to support this work and this channel, then you can take a look at the links in the description down below. There's Patreon, where you can support me directly, and thank you to all of the awesome patrons who already do. You can also check out the Amazon and Overclockers UK affiliate links, which also massively helped me out. And again, thank you to everyone who uses them. It genuinely makes a difference in if I can pay the rent this month, so thank you very much to you guys. There's also a load of other links. There's private internet access, which is a good and cheap VPN, a Humble Bundle for some cheap games, and a load of other stuff down there too, so you can take a look. Otherwise, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below, and of course feel free to check out the other videos too. Otherwise, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you all in the next video.